Alrighty then. So today we are gonna do a video. Hold on a second here. Today we're gonna do a video on how I trained certain things with Denali.
Can I tell you something just between you and me? When I hear your voice, I know I'm finally free. Every single word is perfect as it can be. And I need you here with me. When you lift me up, I know that I'll never fall. I can speak to you by saying nothing at all. Every single time I find it harder to breathe. Cause I need you here with me. Every day, you're saying the words that I want you to say.
I'm just going to use a slip leash. It's what I use inside my house. It's quick, it's easy. I don't have to have him in a collar because I usually don't have him in a collar in the house. But yeah, that's kind of what we're doing. I am in my PJs. I'm having a hard physical day. I've been doing some more muscle training exercises and physical exercises to kind of help with my joint dislocations, and it's just taken a toll to say the least. But yeah, Denali, come here, good boy. We're just using this vest. This was his training vest that he first got. The only reason I'm using it is to show you some of the more mobility aspects of it, because I kind of need a handle to show you that. His full gear is in my car, but that's kind of what we're doing. But yeah. So first off, we're gonna do how I taught Denali to do a cover or pressure therapy. You're gonna need treats. Denali does it fine without them, but you're gonna need treats for your dog. So basically how I started was, Denali, come. Over here, there you go. Okay, so obviously you're gonna have your dog in a heel. I'm gonna scoot over here actually so you can see. Hold on, bud. Over here. Scoot over here so you can see him better. Heel. Heel. There you go. Just so you can see us better in frame. Usually I would use something different, but this is what I've got. It's what I use in the house. Denali. So what you're going to want to do is you're going to want them to smell. And what I usually do is I do give them a couple treats, just so they know that I'm not going to gyp them, that I do have food. And then what we're going to do here is what I did with him is I encouraged by adding a little bit of pressure and guiding their nose. Denali, up. And that is how I got him to first do an up over me. A full cover, cover, cover. Good boy. Again, lure with the food. You only apply an itty bitty amount of pressure and then you just hold them there. Off. And that's how you kind of teach DPT. It's one of the easiest to teach. There's a couple other options that you can use. For more stubborn dogs, you can guide them more with a regular harness, not like this, like a walking harness, kind of guide them on you. I know. I know. He knows I have food now. But heel. Now? No. He's doing what he thinks I want him to do. Off. Off. Heel. Now. Thank you. These are his favorite treats, but it's a good boy. Sit. Now. Thank you. But that's how you do DPT. Basically, what I'm going to do now is a little bit more difficult. DPT, fast, easy. It's pretty easy. A touch command is a little bit harder. What I suggest is look up how to target online right here on YouTube, and it'll walk you through. You need your dog to know how to target before you do this. So you can use target tape or stickers. You can use a taped up box, that's what I used, or you could even just use your hand. And basically what I did is Denali up, is Denali touch, touch, no, Denali touch, come on, touch, touch, I know, sit, 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 no, Booker, sit. I might have to put my sister's cat away because he is a food hound and now he knows I have food. Sit. Now. Thank you. Touch. Okay, that was a nose touch. So that was a little bit harder to see. Denali up. Yeah, hold on. Denali down. Stay. I'm gonna have to put my sister's cat away. Give me a second. Yep, come on. I'm trying to train with Denali to be a ball. I know, because I have food. Denali, come here. All right. Let me see. That's better. All right, come here. Get. 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 Thank you. So I'll show you that later, but with touch, it's much easier. Denali, touch. As soon as they go to put their nose on you, if you're gonna do a nose touch, that's how you teach that. Doing a foot touch is a little bit more difficult. What I did is I started with a box on the ground, and then as he would paw for the food and he would touch that box, I would treat him immediately until he figured out that I wanted him to use his foot. So how Denali knows now with touch is to touch my leg. Denali, touch, touch, not with your face, touch, thank you, is with his foot. He does two different touches. One is with his face and the other is with his foot. It just kind of depends on what's going on. Him doing a touch alert on my leg is for syncope. Denali, touch. Good boy. And he also does touches on my hands. He does do self-harm alerts. So Denali. Yes, good boy. Nudging my hands away, pawing at my hands to get me to stop touching myself, those kinds of things. Same thing, I have a treat in my hand right here. Good boy. So for him to keep me from scratching myself. Same thing goes. Yes, good boy. It's to keep me from scratching my face. Good boy. Those were easy. I'm not gonna lie, they're pretty easy. Same concept, have treats in your hand. As soon as your dog starts to have interest, treat them. Over time, you can get them to be more adamant and to continue to do it more consistently. Denali's been doing self-harm disruptions for about 3 months. Excuse me. He did some other psych tasks, but not until recently did I start to teach him specific tasks. He is not a psych dog. He doesn't do psychiatric alerts. He just does the self-harming disruptions. That's kind of all I need him to do psych-wise. But, yeah, that's kind of how we did that. And then we're going to do how we did. We'll do retrievals. Basically, what I did when I started teaching him a retrieval was to turn it into a game. Denali. Oh, 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 oh. Yes, good boy. As soon as he showed any interest of putting his mouth on the object, he got a treat. So, Denali. Yes, good boy. And slowly but surely, the more he got interested in it, the more we became a game. When he got interested in it. He automatically brings it back now. But he needs to understand that the items that I'm asking him to get for me. Heal. Over here. Come heal. The items that I'm asking him to get for me are toys to him. The best way to teach a dog how to do a retrieval is by making it a game. I can do some other footage. I'll try and inlay here.
Okay, Denali. Get. Get. Yes. Good boy. Ready? Go get. You're a good boy. Good boy. Ready?
Again, I started working with this with toys. Denali, drop.
Get. Bring it. Thank you. Good boy. Go get. Bring it.
Oh, almost.
Bring it. Bring it.
He's done. He's walking off. He's done with the day. He's done. Denali. Bring it back. Thank you. Yeah, he just wants to play. So that's how I originally taught it, was with toys. But eventually you can start going to boxes and leashes and things like that that are on the floor. Actually, let me see here, because there's a sock over here on the floor already.
Denali. Go get. Go get. Over here. Not that one. Nope. Drop. Go get. Get. Leave it. Go get. Go get. Get. Go get. Get it. Go get it. Over there. Go get. Get. Get it. Yes. Good boy.
But yeah, eventually you'll get to the point where you can just ask them to pick up random things that are on the ground. You don't even have to throw them. Go ahead. You can get your toy. And you don't even have to ask. But yeah, that's kind of how that works. Huh. Denali's going to go have a play now. To show him doing some more retrievals, but Denali, ready? Get. Get. Good boy. Turn it into a game. Make them think that this is just the same as a ball. Yeah, good boy. This is just the same as a ball. It's just the same as a rope toy. Basically the same thing. Hold. Drop. Good boy. I didn't mean to give him that big of a bite, but he'll be there for a second. But yeah. Same thing when you teach hold, what I did for him, this is still something that we are working on with him, is for him to learn how to hold objects. Denali, hold, drop, good boy. It's not long. I'm not asking him to hold it for very long, but just long enough for him to understand that that's what I want. I don't want him to drop the object immediately. Same thing, Denali, hold. Drop. Good boy. And the more and more you do it, the more and more you work with the dog, the longer they're going to hold it. How I got him to do this, same idea, make it into a game. And what I did is it's not a full force hold. A force hold method is where you put the toy in their mouth and you hold their mouth closed on the item. Some dogs that works, other dogs it does not. Denali did pretty good with it in the beginning, but I personally thought that doing it a different way would work better. So what I did was Denali hold, and I held it down here. Ah, leave it. Yes, good boy. And as soon as he stopped trying to spit it out, I take it off. I'm not holding this on his mouth. It's like this, just so that way it doesn't fall out. If he freaks out, if he backs up, if he doesn't want it, I take it out. The true force hold method is basically forcing the dog to hold it whether they like it or not. I personally didn't, I didn't like it. I had somebody try it with him and I just, was it working? Yes. Did I like it? Not really. You know, worst comes to worst, if that's the way that your dog learns, okay. But that's not what I was comfortable with working with him. So, thank you. So that's kind of how we did it. Yes, good boy. Take, drop. Good boy. That's kind of how we did a retrieval and with a hold. So when it comes to doing mobility work, I have recently gotten a lot of questions about doing mobility work. This is going to come with a disclaimer. Unless your dog has been cleared for mobility, and unless you have a dog big enough for you, do not do mobility with your dog. Don't. Because just don't. Denali is a light mobility dog, but in emergency situations, he does help me balance myself in a bracing position. I do not put my weight on my dog. He is strictly there to keep me from falling over to the other side. So, Denali, come. Over here, come on. No, leave toy, drop it. No toys, come over here. Tap, tap. Good boy, heel. Heel, now, no. Now you're just doing stuff to get treats. Heel. Now, come heel. Thank you. Now, you want your dog to line up next to you. Counterbalance wise, basically what you do is, I'm going to have him help me up here. Good boy. And basically, what he does is, come, Denali, right here, line up to where he needs to be in the right position to help me walk. And then he just, round, two, this way. He walks beside me, turn around, while holding on to this. And that's kind of how counterbalance is. When I wobble, he stays in place. It's a lot like an anchor to help hold me in position. Counterbalance work is a more light mobility task. Denali does do forward momentum pulling. That one is basically just allowing your dog, giving them a release word, allowing them to go ahead of you. I need to sit down or I'm gonna mess. Okay. Come over here. Heel. Look. I know. Come here. I know. You'll get toy play in a minute. Basically, go ahead. Thank you. He's giving me things now. I know, you're a good boy. Forward momentum pulling is going to be where the dog goes ahead of you to help give you forward momentum. Now, Denali doesn't do a lot of it anymore. He used to do some of it. But
hello. Hey, where do you want this?
On the couch, it's fine. He used to do a lot more of it, but now that I have my wheelchair
and put pants on.
My wheelchair and my smart drive, I don't really have to worry about it that much. So he really doesn't do it. He does do more forward momentum pulling when I am standing. It helps me with my gait to be able to walk faster without falling over, but he doesn't do it very often. Like I said, that one, you're going to give them a release word. They're going to walk ahead of you. And when they're far enough ahead of you, that's the point that you want. Congratulate them, tell them yes, and treat them. And basically over time, when you give them that word, you can change it from a release word into the forward momentum word. Which Denali's is usually go ahead. And over time, they learn that that's the position they're supposed to be in. Now, for brace work, again, this is for people whose dogs are big enough to do this. Denali, come here. Now, come here. Leave Kiki alone. Come here. Now, leave Kiki alone. Thank you. The cat is still trying to get food. Lily! No, no Kiki. Come here. Denali. He's trying to play. With brace work, basically how I taught Denali to do brace work was I would sit and Denali, hey, pay attention. I would push down on his shoulders and say brace. And when he would tense, good boy, tense and stand square, that was a treat. Denali, brace. Good boy. I'm not putting a bunch of weight down on him to teach him this. It's just enough to where you can feel that he is sturdy. Good boy. He knows now if I put my hand on his back right there what he's supposed to do. So it's kind of hard to show what it looks like on a dog that doesn't know how to do that. I would have to honestly get one of my friend's dogs to show you. But thank you. My fuzzy socks. Come here. Bring it then. I dropped one. He's bringing me his toys. He wants to play. But it's kind of hard to show on a dog that already knows how to do it. So then I'll come. So basically what we're going to show now is some standing alerts. It's going to be a little bit more difficult for me. I'm having, like I said, a pretty bad physical day. So I might have to do it in intervals, but that's kind of just how it's going to have to go. Denali, come. Come. Thank you. All right. So, essentially what we're going to do here, I'm going to move my chair over here. Lock it so if I fall over, I can just get to my chair. And then I'm going to show you essentially how Denali does standing alerts. Denali, come. Over here. No, we're not playing with ball right now. Come. Thank you. You. Right here. Thank you, Stan. So essentially what we're going to do is I'm going to show the physical signs that I show before I have syncope and Denali alerts before that happens. Now, he does do scent alerts, but this is how I originally taught him before we did scent work. What I wanted him to do so that I could eventually move into the scent work. Denali, step back. Step back. All the way. Thank you. So, essentially, that's what you're going to see. Denali. Yes, good boy. Again, that is same thing. The touch command. And teaching him while I was doing the physical symptoms, I would tell him to touch. And over time, I got to the point where I didn't have to tell him to do the command while I was showing the symptoms. Same thing. Yes, good boy. Huffing at my hands while standing, trying to get me to stop. Same thing goes, we're going to try and do, I don't really do the standing psych tasks very often because I usually am on the ground, but yes, good boy, to pull my hands away from my face. He is on the ball tonight. Yeah, you know what you're doing, huh? Good boy. Sit. Good boy. So yeah, essentially that's what we're looking for. But basically that's kind of how I taught him how to do that. Denali, up, up, thank you. But that's kind of how I taught him how to do that. Same thing goes with the standing tasks. Same thing, you're gonna teach the alert task that you want first. You want to do the alert task first. And then basically you just shape it as you go. I definitely will do a Denali cam. Hey. You. Over here. Come here. All the way. Not a block. Come here. Thank you. I'll have to show a more in-depth video of breaking down how to do a touch task. I'll have to see if I can't use my friend's dog to do it, because she doesn't know how to do it yet, to kind of show you what it looks like from the beginning. Okay. But, yeah, that's kind of how that is. I need to sit down, didn't I? Mush. But that's kind of a crash course in how to do them and teach them. I am really dizzy. But to kind of show you how that works. Ta-da. No. You can't just throw toys at me. You ding dong. Come here. So we're going to see if he will get this box on the ground. Didn't throw it, nothing. I'm just going to ask him to get it. I don't want the ball. Drop. Come over here. Get. Get. No, not that one. Okay, thank you. Get. 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 Thank you. So... sometimes it takes them giving you everything under the sun, but eventually you will get what you want. I know, there you go. But that's kind of what to do. Let's see here. I do kind of want to show you the breakdown of how to do a touch command. We can kind of do, Denali, come here, now. Thank you for the toy. I don't need him right now. Come here. Heel. No. I know. I know. But, I don't want you to snuggle me. I love you too. Sit. I'm well aware. Thank you. So, that was actually him telling me that I am really dizzy. Not gonna lie. I need to lean back. Good boy. Here. That was good. Go get. Sometimes, listen to your dog. Standing up that long and then going back and forth has made my head spin. Oh God. I know, you're a good boy. Excuse me. Come here. So we can show the people how to do a touch and then we're done. Come here. Now, come here. Drop. Thank you. Come. No, leave him. Leave him. Come here. Now, Denali. No. No. Heel. Now. And sometimes your dog tells you the training session is over before you want it to be over. Go ahead. Go ahead. Take it. I know. We'll be done. Go on. So... I'll have to do another video on the beginning of how to train the touch. I'm having some brain fog now too, so I think I'm probably going to end this as it is, because I don't want to make it worse and actually get sick. So, yeah. I hope this helped some people kind of see how to start with the training sessions and how to kind of start working on those kinds of things with their dog. And I will show some retrieval stuff with him. And this video, hopefully I already had put it in, but yeah, I hope it helped. If you guys have any more questions or anything in here that you want more in depth, like, comment, subscribe. Holly, like, comment, and subscribe, and let me know what you want to see, and what kind of training things you think that I need to go more in depth with. Denali also does button pushing and things like that. With that is also another form of the touch command. So if you're interested on that, I do have a live video on doing the touch command in my videos that goes a little bit more in depth on that as well, doing lights and things. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed, and we will see you next time. Bye.